Hi, my name's Paul Hill. I'm the Global Cybersecurity Offer Manager for Motorola Solutions. Today I'm demonstrating cybersecurity and showing the importance of basic technical controls such as antivirus and operating system patches. To demonstrate this, I have put together three virtual machines. The first one that you can see up here, as the background suggests, is a vulnerable target. There's no antivirus, there's no firewall, and there's no operating system patches. The machine here to the left, this demonstrates the hacker. Now this is the real life tools that a hacker will use to compromise systems out in the wild. The system that I've got on the right of the screen is a protected target. It's got up-to-date antivirus, it's got up-to-date and operating system patches and an active firewall. The first part of this demonstration is to show that if you've got a machine which is protected with these basic technical controls, it makes it extremely difficult to propagate malware to it. I've created this Trojan horse for the purpose of this demonstration, and just by trying to simply drag and drop it to the system, you can see that the protected system instantly detects that it is a variant of a Trojan horse, and it stops propagation in this instance. The second part of the demonstration is where we get a little bit more technical. We often see emails and literature online about don't click links, don't put USB sticks into computers, but we very rarely see what happens when we do this. So now I'm going to show you this. And I'm sure you'll agree that it's very simple to do it. So on my vulnerable target, if I try to open up what looks like Internet Explorer, you can see that nothing happens on screen, but over on my hacking station, I have opened up a window and I've now got full administrative control over this system. Now that I have this, there is a whole host of things that I can do on the system. The first thing I can do is that I can remotely execute applications. I can also start a keylogging device which will capture all of the keystrokes on this machine. So let's imagine that you're on a network management console and you're logging into the system with your super secure password. Then all along, because you were a victim of the malware attack previously, you can see that we've been able to capture all of these strokes and that the hacker's intent may now have been completed. The final things that I can show you is that you can also remotely kill applications. And with a lot of our public safety customers, the main concern is availability of their system. In the moments that matter, they need high availability on their systems. So if you've got an attacker who just wants to cause disruption to the system, then they can remotely reboot the system as well. What we're starting to see is that public safety systems are making extremely attractive targets for hackers, whether it's financially incentivized, socially or politically. The public safety systems are a real target. The time where cybersecurity was a nice thing to have is over. Cybersecurity controls on a system is now essential.